Hi, welcome back to Strategic Planet. Today I want to spend a little bit of time explaining how NVivo can be used to enhance the literature review process when embarking on a PhD. This is really important because you will be reading literally hundreds of articles and you will need some form of mechanism to capture and file the relevant bits which you will want to retrieve later when you finally start writing. Also, as a future researcher, having a process that allows you to easily pull up relevant literature will make you a more effective and efficient academic. Finally, what I'm about to show you utilizes the principles of thematic analysis, so it will also be an excellent way of understanding this aspect of qualitative research. Now, I'm actually using NVivo for Mac, so the view that you see on the screen will be slightly different if you have the Windows-based version of NVivo. Many students I speak to are put off from using NVivo because they look at it and they can see a vast amount of functionality within the program. And they think that it's just too much to learn. Don't worry, I'm only going to focus really on two areas, and that is the internal sources and the nodes. And that's all you need to know really for the literature review process. Now, what you can see in front of you is my example of a literature review for social marketing. I'm going to give you an overall summary of what you can actually do with NVivo in the literature review process. And then once you've seen that and understand how it can be used, I will go through step by step of what you need to do. We start with sources and internals. Here I have a collection of snippets of information that I consider to be important. They are grouped by source, i.e. a journal article or book or website, etc. And I've named each source after the author and year it was produced, which is the classical referencing style. Now, what you can see in the main window is the snippet of information. It starts with the name of your source. So here we can see I've got the first one, Alexander and Schmidt, 1996. The number of nodes or themes, and then the number of references. Now, to explain what these two mean here, it's best if I use this example here, which is Evans et al. So if I just open that up, what you can see, Evans et al. Go down a bit more. It's got one node and two references. And what that means is that the one node or theme is branding, but it's done twice. And that's what the difference between references and nodes is. You can then see the date it was created on, who it was created by, if you're working with other individuals, the date it might have been modified, and who it was modified on. So you really have to focus on the name that we've got here. Now, the other important element of NVivo is the nodes, which you can see here on the left-hand side. A node is synonymous with a theme. So for those of you who are familiar with thematic analysis, just replace themes for nodes. What happens is, as you read an article or a book, you highlight a few words or a sentence or even a paragraph and say to yourself, I'm going to give that highlighted element a specific node or theme. That way, when you have finally structured your literature review, you can create sections within it that has all the relevant articles that you have read. So these are all my nodes for social marketing. Let me just move that to the top and bring this down a bit. You can see each node that I've created here and the number of sources and references that I've got within it. Let me just sort it by the most. So if I go to the top here, definition is a good example. What I now have are a list of all the articles related to definition. So we've got Laser and Kelly, Andreasen 1994, Andreasen 2002, Andreasen 2006, etc., etc., etc. So when I'm writing my section within the literature review about definitions, I've got a whole list of sources that I can pick out here that I would have read over maybe a couple of years, and you don't often keep that in your memory. So this process of using NVivo allows me to keep that information close to hand and call it up when I need it, and that's why it's so important. As I mentioned earlier, NVivo has so many different functionalities, but I've just focused on the sources, internals, and nodes as the two elements to help me manage the literature review process, and that's all you need. Hopefully you can see how powerful the tool is. Now what I want to do is to go through step by step on how you actually go through each stage of the process.